Iraq is going to produce a large amount of oil. So the main reason behind the Operation Desert Storm was to free Kuwait from the Iraqis. Okay, so this was the task taken by the US. So at that time, President George Bush was the president of USA. So he took the initiative of launching. First, it was known as the Operation Desert Shield, and later on, it was known as Operation Desert Storm. Okay, now, so the first major crisis, foreign crisis for the United States after the end of the Cold War, presented itself in August 1990. So Saddam Hussein, he was the dictator of Iraq, and he had ordered his army to cross the border into tiny Kuwait. So Kuwait was also an oil producing nation. So now it was taken over by Iraq. So at that time, who was the president of Iraq? It was Saddam Hussein, and he was a great dictator. Okay. Now, so this was no ordinary act of aggression. So it was not an ordinary act of aggression. Aggression means to take over someone else's nation. So the United States had provided massive military aid to the Iraq during the eight-year war with Iran, giving them the fourth largest army in the world. So in the beginning, in the year 1980 to 1988, so USA had given a lot of help to Iran in order to fight with Iraq. Okay? So at that time now, the Iraqi armies had grown to a very high level. Okay? That means given them the fourth largest army in the world. So in the war between Iran and Iraq, USA had given a great help to Iraq. But now what was happening? Now USA was now challenging, or was trying to put an end to the Iraqi rule over Kuwait. So Kuwait was a major supplier of oil to the United States. So United States was getting oil from Kuwait, but now it was coming under the control of the Iraqis. Okay? So the Iraqi takeover posed an immediate threat to neighboring Saudi Arabia, another major exporter of oil. So if Saudi Arabia fell to Saddam, Iraq would control one-fifth of the world's oil supply. So all eyes were on the White House waiting for a response. President Bush, who succeeded President Reagan, stated simply, this will not stand. Okay, so now, Kuwait was supplying oil to USA. But now it had come under the control of the Iraqi. That means Saddam Hussein had now occupied Kuwait. Okay? Now it posed a great threat to Saudi Arabia as well. So Saudi Arabia is also very close by Kuwait. Okay? So now if Iraq starts to control the oil producing nations, then what would have happened? Now Iraq would control one-fifth of the oil supply. So yeah. So Operation Desert Storm was the first major foreign crisis for the United States after the end of the Cold War. So on August 2nd, 1990, so Saddam Hussein, he led a well-equipped Iraqi army into Kuwait, a major supplier of oil to the United States. So on August 2nd, Saddam Hussein now, he moved forward towards Kuwait, and Kuwait was a country which used to supply oil to the USA. Now, so he was Saddam Hussein, okay, the president of Iraq at that time. So now, President Bush announced the start of what would be called Operation Desert Storm, a military operation. So what was the main motive behind the Desert Operation Storm? To expel occupying Iraqi forces from Kuwait. So the Iraqi forces were occupying Kuwait. So the main motive behind Operation Desert Storm was to remove these Iraqi forces. Okay. So which Iraq had invaded and annexed months earlier. So while coalition casualties were in the hundreds, Iraqi losses numbered in the tens of thousands. So coalition means USA with the support of some of the nations, isn't it? So they have tried to liberate Kuwait from the Iraqis. So now clash took place between US coalition troops and the Iraqis. Okay, so as a result, what happened was the US forces lost about hundreds of soldiers, but the Iraqi losses numbered in the tens of thousands. Okay, so more than 5 lakhs American troops deployed to Saudi Arabia as part of the Operation Desert Shield. It was known as Desert Shield in the beginning. So in case Iraqi troops attacked Saudi Arabia. So now USA was also ready. So in case, okay, the Iraqis attack Saudi Arabia, now they have to be ready in order to fight the Iraqi troops. Okay, so in case Iraqi troops attack Saudi Arabia. So this was how the US troops now went into point. So on 15th January 1991, Operation Desert Shield became Operation Desert Storm, backed by public support after diplomacy failed. So now USA was supported by a large number of nations, and then they were out to liberate Kuwait from the clutches of the Iraqis. Okay? So Desert Storm became the largest air campaign since the conflict in Southeast Asia. That means now Kuwait began to be attacked from the air as well. Okay, in order to liberate Kuwait from the clutches of the Iraqis. And then this is a 5-4-2 tangle on February 25th, 1991. So you can see US military vehicles seen in the desert in Iraq on the second day of the massive ground assault into Kuwait and Iraq. Okay, so a large amount of soldiers, not only soldiers, okay, the you can see the amount of vehicles also that was employed in order to free the country of Kuwait. So now the US and the 40 allied nations, including several Arab nations, flew more than 80,000 air deployment missions, more than 1,16,000 combat air sorties, and dropped 85,500 tons of bombs. Okay, so a large amount of weapons, arms and ammunition and weapons were used in this particular war. So after air attacks that lasted for 6 weeks, so the air attacks did not last for 1 week or 2 weeks, but it lasted for about 6 weeks, more than a month. So the ground campaign lasted only 100 hours before Kuwait was liberated. So finally Kuwait was liberated. Okay, so now, so Saddam Hussein, you know, he was the dictator of Iraq. So what had he done? He had occupied Kuwait. Okay, and then the Iraqi army was well equipped, because we know that in the Iran-Iraq war, so USA had given a lot of help to Iraq. So it was well equipped, and Iran had become the fourth largest army in the world. So Kuwait was a major supplier of oil to the US, and it was a great threat to Saudi Arabia. Okay, now, and after that, now what happened was, now the US issued an ultimatum to Saddam Hussein to leave Kuwait by January 15, 1991, or face a full attack by the multinational force Desert Shield or the Desert Storm. That means it's not that USA directly attacked Iraq, okay, or it did not directly attack the Iraq forces, but it had given an ultimatum. That means it had given a time, USA had given a time that Saddam Hussein had to leave Kuwait by January 15, 1991, okay, or he had to face the attack. So that's why Kuwait was attacked by the US forces in order to liberate it from the Iraqi forces and the dictator Saddam Hussein. Okay, so on January 16, 1991, President George H.W. Bush announced the start of what was called the Operation Desert Storm. Okay, so we know that it was a military operation to expel occupying Iraqi forces from Kuwait. So there was no response from the Iraqi, so that's why the USA started to bombard Kuwait. Okay, and it began to target not only from the land but even from the air and the sea. Okay, so the Iraqis wanted the support from other Arabian countries, but they did not get any help from other countries. Okay, Now, so this was the picture of the Gulf War. So, how USA began to attack Kuwait in order to liberate it from the Iraqi forces. Yeah, that's it, the pictures. Isn't it? By air also, by sea also, by land. So, a lot of bombardment took place. Now, so what Iraq tried to do is, it tried to split the coalition by launching Scud missiles at Israel, but Israel refrained from responding thanks to its partnership with the United States. So now, since Iraqi troops were being targeted by the US coalition, so now it wanted to get the help of Israel. So what it did was, it tried to split the coalition, because Israel was also in support of the USA. But what happened was, the Iraqi tried to launch Scud missiles at Israel, but Israel did not respond to it. Had Israel responded, maybe the war would have been bigger than this. Okay, so Israel was in support of the United States, it did not fire or backfire any missiles. So yeah, here also it is being attacked. So this was the aftermath of the war. So the large oil fields were set on fire. Okay. So these were the devastation which was created after the Gulf War. Now, so this was Iraq. Okay? So this map shows initial air attacks of Desert Storm made by the Allied forces early in the morning on January 17, 1989. So this was Iraq. Okay, initial air attacks. And a deserted Iraqi tank crashed near a series of oil well fires during the Gulf War on March 9, 1991 in northern Kuwait. So these were the Iraqi forces which had occupied Kuwait. So this was what was left after the Kuwait War. So about 697,000 US troops had taken part in the war, with 299 losing their lives. Okay, so this was all about the Operation Desert Storm. So the main motive behind the Operation Desert Storm was not only to liberate Kuwait, okay, but we can see the influence of the USA. So USA had taken the decision to free the country of Kuwait from the Iraqis, okay, especially to remove or to protect Kuwait from the Iraqi troops. Okay, and later on, it was successful in liberating. Okay, so this was all about the Operation Desert Storm. So with this, we come to the end of the explanation of the Desert Storm. So in the next class, we shall continue with the US-Iraqi freedom. So in all of these operations, so three of these operations, so what we see, okay, is the involvement of the USA. So in USA taking its own decision without taking into consideration the views of the other nations. So that's why it is known as the Unipolar World or Unilateralism. Okay?